Let's study the LCAO process for the molecule ethane and come up with a simple language for describing localized bonding in this molecular orbital picture. First, what are the atomic orbitals that are involved? Each carbon atom contributes 4 atomic orbitals. There's a 2s, a 2p, x, y, and z. There are 2 carbon atoms, and so carbon altogether is going to contribute 8 atomic orbitals. On hydrogen, each hydrogen atom is going to contribute 1 atomic orbital, that's the 1s orbital. There are 6 hydrogen atoms altogether, and so hydrogen in total contributes 6 atomic orbitals. Altogether, we've got 14 atomic orbitals. We should expect that there will be 14 molecular orbitals created by the LCAO process. We're not going to generate all of them. We'll just generate the ones that are occupied and the one antibonding orbital that's lowest in energy. The lowest energy molecular orbital has 0 nodes. It combines the 2s orbitals on carbon constructively with the 1s orbitals on each of the hydrogen atom. Next above that, we're still using hydrogen 1s and carbon 2s, but now we've created a node right between the 2 carbon atoms. And so the one node is a higher in energy orbital. It's a sigma s, and we'll put it as a sigma s prime. It's still mostly bonding. Just above that, we still have one node, but now we're introducing 2pz orbitals on each of the carbon atoms. Notice that the node lies in the plane where the node of the pz orbital is. And so you can see that everything above that plane has the same sign. Everything below that plane has the same sign. Even though there's only one node in these two cases, they're higher in energy than the case that we saw down here because pi bonding is involved, side-by-side bonding of these pz orbitals instead of sigma bonding of these 2s orbitals. Pi bonding is weaker than sigma bonding, and that's why the energy of interaction keeps this above that sigma s prime orbital that we generated. Next above that, we're still using the carbon 2p orbitals, but now the 2px orbitals that combine constructively here, but because they're on their sides, there's going to be 2 nodes, 2 nodal planes that are introduced. And so we have an energy that's higher than the one node cases that we had below that. The highest occupied pair of orbitals involve pi type bonding. It's actually pi star bonding. You can see there's a change in sign in those pz orbitals that align side by side. So we have a nodal plane that cuts through between the carbon atoms. That's one of the nodal planes that exist. And then the second nodal plane exists where the lobes on those pz orbitals change signs. So again, the things that are above that plane have the same sign, while the lobes that are below that plane also have the same sign. There are 2 nodal planes in all. They're pi type interactions, and so they're above this sigma type interaction. These are the highest occupied molecular orbitals. We've used all the electrons up, so the next orbital above that is the lowest unoccupied molecular orbital. This is very similar to the orbital that's shown here, except notice now we've inverted the phase of one of those px orbitals, and so there's a nodal plane between the 2 carbon atoms. There's also nodal planes where those p orbitals change signs, so there's 3 nodes altogether. The greater the number of nodes, the higher the energy. In this case, it's an unoccupied orbital. It's the lowest unoccupied molecular orbital. Even though the molecular orbital model doesn't allow us to associate a specific molecular orbital to a particular bond, chemists often look at these pictures and identify what would be a sigma and a sigma star bonding as being derived from a pair of p orbitals that come together to make that kind of constructive and destructive overlap. So for simplicity, this is a very localized view, but it's derived from these pictures. And anytime we need to understand the complete description of a bond, recognize that it's fully available in the complete set of molecular orbitals. Before you leave this page, be sure to check out the Darmstadt site There's some more great interactive graphics showing the molecular orbitals of ethane.